Great opportunity with a great organization. What they've done the last few years, playing against them on the other side of the ball, I wanted to add what I, you know, my specialties to it, and we felt like we had mutual interest.
Was it a difficult decision? Did you have several other teams that you had to decide from?
Yes, there were a couple other teams, and then obviously, you know, these last week or so, ever since camp started, things heated up. But I liked what I heard from the Chiefs. That's why I came out here to meet with them in person to see how I fit, see how they would use me, see how I would contribute, see if it was a fit, and I'm here.
Did any specific players recruit you at all?
No.
You know that you work out with Orlando Brown and also Chris Jones down in Miami. How much did they talk to you? How much did you ask them about Kansas City?
With the offers and stuff, they weren't down there at the same time. I think they were in OTAs when the first offer came. So I didn't really get that, but I had trained with them. We had worked out together, did all our stuff, you know, normal individually, you know, not knowing that I was going to be a Chief. So when I got here today, he's like, we didn't even know this was going to be a real thing. Both of them pretty much said that. So it's kind of cool that we already got to know each other a little bit this offseason because we've been working together.
Carlos, you signed a little bit later in free agency. What went into just that timetable for you?
Patience, you know. This is my 13th year. I've done it 12 different ways. So I wanted to make sure I made an educated decision and went with a team, you know, where, you know, there was, you know, mutual interest in, you know, my ability to play and how I'll be used and the opportunity to win. Because at this point, you know, I've done a lot of football. One of the things I have not done is, you know, I haven't got over 100 sacks, I haven't won a playoff game, and I haven't clearly won a Super Bowl. So those are things that I would like to do at this point in my career, and I'm in hot pursuit, and I feel like this team gives me a great opportunity, the best opportunity to do it. So, you know.
Speaking of sacks, you've been able to get at least 6 since 2011. What goes into that consistency of just being able to get to the quarterback in the game?
My routine. So that's one of the big things that I'm trying to establish and figure out here. Today was the first day. So I contributed to my routine, my work ethic, my team that helps with my routine. So I got to find all the people here, delegate those tasks, and just get a routine and a rhythm going.
Carlos, what did you like to hear most from either Andy Reid or Steve Spagnuolo when you were having those initial conversations and then when you were here before making the decision to sign?
The opportunity to play in every down, obviously we'll be rolling because we got a young bull, first round pick, who has a lot of talent. Sky's the limit for him. So the opportunity to play in every down, you know, at this point in my career, because I've been a closer in so many games and have 96 sacks in my career, you know, they try to correlate, you know, with being older, taking down your snaps, but featuring you in passing situations. But I like to eat and wherever you put on the table, you know,
first downs as much as third downs.
Yeah, I could say it just like that. Yeah, first and second downs are just as important to me as third down. Obviously, I've done many things on third down, closed many games on third down, but I feel like if you impact the game early on first and second down, you can put the game away even sooner. And clearly, these guys have lit up the scoreboard a million and one time, so look forward to contributing my strengths to what they already do well here.
Something special planned if you get that fourth sack?
No, because getting over 100 puts me, in the top, I think I need 103 to get in the top 50-something or 40-something. So I want to shrink that down to at least get to, you know, maybe top 25, 32. So 100 is a big milestone that I will, you know, enjoy and celebrate and be proud of. But 4 sacks on the year is not my goal. As I, you know, try to average 8. He said 6 the last few years, but I try to average 8 a year. And I want to go for more than that, obviously. And I put my money where my mouth is with the deal we did, structured it that way for, you know, the incentives to increase it.
I understand you just got here yesterday, and then today was your first time actually observing the practice from the sidelines.
Yes.
What are your impressions so far as you look at what Steve Spagnuolo's defensive scheme wants you to do and how you fit there?
That's a tough question you should ask me in a couple of days because I'm still learning the defense. I was up to about midnight last night trying to catch up on the install. I believe they're, you know, a few installs ahead of me. I got 2 or 3 of them in yesterday, but today will be the day that I'm going to get with Coach one-on-one and get through it. You know, obviously, you know, it's camp, so there's a lot of things, moving parts going on. Haven't had opportunity yet to sit and just go through it with them, so we're going to do that. So, you know, Give me a little bit of time to answer that question.
You
Coach Cullen, yeah. Oh, yeah. That was another thing that showed the importance of, you know, them wanting me to get here because it's obviously camp. I landed at, 10:30, got here at like 11:30, and the whole staff was here. They had all the things that I wanted to get answered, questions. Each one of them spent time with Coach Reed one-on-one eating pizza. Then we went in there with Spags and Coach Cullen, watched some tape, basically showed me where I would be, the defense they run, how they call it, his rhythm. And I liked where I fit, so, you know, that morning I signed, yeah. So clearly that night was worth it to them and worth it to me, and clearly them taking that initiative to do it in camp, knowing, you know, it's early days. Like today I was woken up at 6 in the morning for a drug test, and, you know, I didn't have to be up till 9. So, you know, I know they have early mornings, so that was pretty dope for them to take that time to answer my questions and take that initiative to, you know, get me here.
Played with Russell Wilson the last couple of years. You excited to go up against him since now he's with the Denver Broncos to get you cracks at him this year?
I definitely have looked at the schedule. Russ is my guy. There's no personal vendetta versus him, but he's on the other side, so I have a job to do just as well as he does. But there's a lot of things on that schedule that I liked and played into my decision as well. So looking forward to getting after it.
Carlos, you mentioned that young goal of George Karloftis. Yeah. What do you feel like is your opportunity to help a young guy like that? And who were some veterans maybe helped you when you entered?
I came up in a different game. I didn't have the greatest vets, you know, in my day because, you know, hazing and all that wasn't exactly illegal or frowned upon. It was encouraged. So, for him, I think the best thing I can give him is, you know, my perspective from experience and try to add to what he already does well. Clearly, he was a first-round pick. I wasn't. So he has something that they saw that they like and they see the potential in him. So I would like to give him whatever tool that I can from my perspective to help him unlock what he already does well. I'm not trying to change him to me. You know, I'm here to – I got a job to do. You know, they already told me what my role will be. And, you know, helping grooming him and helping all the young players along the way is – part of why I understand, you know, my role is at this point in my career, as well as winning and closing games along with them.
Thanks, everyone.
Thanks, Carlos.
Appreciate it. Thank you.